Hi guys, welcome. Today we're looking at the construction of the mandible leg of Highway 2000. Now we're looking at the Rio Mino Bridge in Maypen, Jamaica. This section, the mandible section of Highway 2000, is going to run from the Maypen roundabout to the Williamsfield roundabout in Manchester. So the Maypen roundabout is in Clarendon and it's going to run to Williamsfield in Manchester. Now, Highway 2000 is a project to build a highway from Kingston, Jamaica to Montego Bay. The idea behind it is to connect both major international airports and connect both cities in Jamaica. So the highway is to run from Kingston to Montego Bay. The cost to build the highway was very expensive, so they decided to build it out in phases. So what you're looking at there now is a Maypen roundabout, and that's where the highway starts. So the Kingston to Maypen leg, or from Caymanos to the Maypen roundabout, that leg of the highway is finished and it's up and running. You can drive on it. Dual carriageway, four lanes, very nice road. It's a toll road, so you have to pay toll to use it. And then they're going to build out the rest of the highway in sections. So the section they're working on now is the Mandeville section, which is what we're looking at. So it will connect from where the existing highway ends at the Maypen roundabout and take Highway 2000 all the way to Williamsfield in Manchester. Then from Williamsfield, it will go through St. Elizabeth and then come back down through St. James. And it's going to go through Anchovy and Long Hill and come back down to the Bogue Main Road in Montego Bay. Actually, they're building a perimeter road in Montego Bay. And that project includes building a toll plaza, which is going to be a part of Highway 2000. All right, so this is the Maypen to Mandeville leg. So this section of the highway now is going to cost $188 million. It was scheduled to be completed in March 2023. However, it was recently announced that the highway will be finished over the summer, probably around June 2023. And just to give you a brief rundown of the alignment, the new segment of the highway begins at the western end of the existing Maypen roundabout. It will continue in a westerly direction across the Rio Mino. And that bridge we're looking at is the Rio Mino Bridge, and it crosses the Rio Mino River. The route continues in a westerly direction, passing south of the Bustamante Highway. It passes south of the Four Paths Community, Osborne Store Community, Tollgate Community, and the Clarendon Park Community. Then it heads into St. Tools and continues through the hilly terrain. And then it exits onto the existing Melrose Hill Bypass. And the Melrose Hill Bypass will be incorporated into the new alignment of the highway. So the Melrose Hill Bypass is going to be upgraded from two lanes to four lanes. And it will be a dual carriageway. And then the road crosses the train line and terminates just east of the steel bridge in the vicinity of the Williamsfield roundabout. And this section of the highway is going to be a toll road as well. The entire Highway 2000 project is a toll road. All right, guys. So that's a brief summary of the construction of the Mandeville leg of Highway 2000. A lot of persons just refer to this highway as the Mandeville Highway because it takes you to Mandeville. Now, on the right, that's the Bustamante Highway, and that's the existing bridge. It's a two-lane bridge, and you can see how much bigger the Rio Mino Bridge, or the new bridge, is. And according to the NWA, the Rio Mina Bridge is going to be the widest bridge in Jamaica. Although many persons say the Causeway Bridge, which is six lanes, looks wider, but this bridge, according to... Thank you.